Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Nerdly Out Loud, the official channel of nerdly.co.uk, your favourite British home for all the news, reviews, and exclusive interviews. Now, things are a little bit different right now. I'm sat in an empty shell of a studio. I had to basically take the decision over the last couple of weeks to strip everything back because Storm Arwen done quite a bit more damage than I thought it had. I've got a really crappy sheet behind me. I'm currently recording everything off my iPhone. So if there is a little bit of drop in quality, I do apologize, but I had to bring you everything I needed to do. Again, we are Nerdly Out Loud. We are the official channel of nerdly.co.uk, your favorite British home for all the news, reviews, and exclusive interviews. We like to cover everything from the big budget to the low budget to the no budget. And this time around, I had to sit down and talk about Cobra Kai season 4. I'm a huge Cobra Kai fan. I'm a huge Karate Kid fan from back in the day. I love those movies, all of them, including the one with the girl. I actually thought Hilary Swank was okay. So this review won't be like my normal reviews, which is where we normally follow a sort of routine. I'll try and follow that routine a little bit, but for the most part, this review is just going to be off the cuff and everything like that. Do not worry, I am fully aware that it is just out and not everybody is as crazy as me who at 12 o'clock in the afternoon, as soon as Cobra Kai hit Netflix, I sat and watched the whole 10 episodes all in one go. I realize not everybody's like that. I realize some people have lives and want to go and do other things, but I did. I binged the whole damn thing. So I will be giving you as much as I possibly can without jumping into spoilers, but be aware there may be one or two. There may be, and that's on me, but I will try and stay away from it as much as possible because, I mean, this probably is a spoiler, but I think this is the best series yet. I think year on year, Cobra Kai has just got better. And when YouTube Red, as it was called back in the day, when YouTube Red first announced that these three guys, Josh Hill, Hayden Schlossberg, and John Hurwitz were coming together to make a Karate Kid spinoff based around Cobra Kai, I was kind of in to start with, but I'm like, well, where does that really go? How far can that really go? Can we stretch a full series out? If we can stretch a full series, happy days, but where does it go after that? What the guys did was when they brought it around, they played on theories, they played on pure fan service. Like, there are people out there who view the Karate Kid in a different way, and as such that Daniel's actually the bad guy and Johnny was the good guy in the whole thing. And I like that. And they lean into that. And that's what's great about this show. They just paid the ultimate fan service in a way that only built on the foundation that was already there and improved everything. So I was excited going into Cobra Kai season 4 because at the end of the last season, if you remember, hopefully you do, and this isn't spoilers for most people, but we were in a pretty weird place. Johnny and Danny had kind of started to team up. They were going to be a faction together to take on old nemesis John Kreese. John Kreese's storyline in season 3 was just very well done. Extremely well done with the flashbacks to the Vietnam stuff. I mean, you had that amazing moment of which Kreese gets on the phone, he's calling someone, you know who he's calling, I know who he's calling. It's not a spoiler because he is on the bloody poster. Terry Silver is coming back. I could not wait to hear Terry Silver say Danny Boy again as a fan, because they have done this through the years where they've given us things that we loved and we wanted to see again, but they've shown us it in a different way or in a different light. And just, I wanted to see Terry Silver back. I wanted to see where Terry Silver was these days. I had a big hope that Bad Boy of Karate Mike Barnes was coming back. No spoilers on that at all. Let's get into this a little bit and let's talk about Cobra Kai.
And now, our feature presentation.
Yes, as we know, Danny and Johnny have got together. They are teaming up. They are going to try and take down Cobra Kai at the All Valley Tournament. And that is what season 4 is. But the crux of this series is basically getting us to that tournament. Are Daniel and are Johnny going to be able to coexist? Is Miyagi-Do and Eagle Fang going to be able to coexist? Are these groups of fighters, people who have been under the Eagle Fang slash Cobra Kai umbrella, or people who have been under the Miyagi-Do umbrella, are these fighters going to be able to coexist and, you know, team up to take on the badasses that are Cobra Kai? And then, of course, you've got the Cobra Kai guys who Robbie's now gone over there. Johnny's son, Robbie, is now there. He's had Miyagi-Do training. He's had Cobra Kai training. He's now going to bring that to the table as well. So you've got all these fantastic little stories. Tori gets a way bigger story arc in this series. I really rate Peyton List in this series. Tori Nichols is a fascinating character, almost taking the mantle of the Robbie kind of character, because Robbie's sort of on the fence now. We don't really know where his allegiance lies. Is he doing everything for himself, or is he just trying to get back at his dad? Does he really care about karate at all? Tori Nichols does care about karate, and she cares because it's all she really has. And this series, they lean into that heavy. And I think Peyton List did a superb job this whole series. And I'm going to say the same for Jacob Bertrand as Eli Hawk. You know, his storyline this year was just compelling as hell. It really, really was. We didn't really know where it was going to go, because obviously at the tail end of the last series, he kind of switched sides right at the last minute when he saw Miguel was actually in pain and he thought he could help him. And then him and Dimitri started teaming up. It was just a great moment. I loved that moment, but we pay that off even more so. But of course, are the guys going to take to him coming back? How are the Cobra Kai people going to take to him now that he's basically a traitor? You know, they're really going to go after him. And Eli has a really good storyline this year as well. I think for me, the MVPs of this season are actually, like, story-wise, don't get me wrong, there's some really good action for everyone else, but story-wise, the MVPs of this season for me are Hawk and Tori. But let's talk about just the fact that Johnny and Daniel are now a team. Like, how the hell are they going to coexist all this time? I think we knew that the show was going to take us there. You know, of course they're going to be old enemies, but we kind of know that that's where the show is going to go. They have to, I guess, become friends at some point. They have to team up at some point. And bringing in Kreese, the man who just abused and just mentally tortured Johnny back in the day, but then bringing Terry Silver into the mix, because of course our two good guys are now going to team up, so you're going to have the bad guys team up. Terry Silver coming into it and playing on the whole army mentality, the military mentality that these guys have. Terry, when we first find him, he doesn't want none of it. He's like, dude, I'm done with all that. I've got this new karma kind of thing going on. I'm all about the peaceful life, and I loved that. But of course he's going to come back because he served in the military with Kreese. And for those who know, I mean, I'm not saying that I know, but I've seen enough of it and I know enough people who have, there's a bond, there's a connection there. Whether they are your strength or your weakness, there's a connection there. And that's kind of what brings Terry back into the fold. We get to see a fantastic little back and forth with Kreese and Silver, but also back and forth between Silver and Daniel, Silver and Johnny. You know, Johnny, like, it's so cool because you forget Johnny doesn't actually know who Terry Silver is. It's so cool to see. Just, I love the fact that these guys are just total fans of the films, total fans of this universe, and are basically writing their own fan fiction. But it just happens to be my fan fiction as well, and I think most people out there. We got some new characters. We got some great new characters. We also got some characters coming back. We get Aisha back for an episode. And one thing on that, and I think this goes down to the plot lines and the story-wise, like, Aisha basically gives Sam Larusso, like, a little bit of advice. I'm going to say it now, I don't think Sam took that advice the way Aisha meant it. That's all I'm going to say about that. Xolo Mariduena, who plays Miguel, I don't really think he had a great deal to do. He had a nice little arc, and his arc was pretty cool, but I guess they were kind of trying to get us to this point where they can maybe write him out for a season, or even, like, have him less in the next season, because, of course, he's off to make DC's Blue Beetle. We all know that. So they kind of use this series to get him to a point where it's like, you know what, we might not need you as much next series. So that's all good. You go off and do your thing. Go and make your Blue Beetle movie. Not to say his story isn't compelling, because he still moves a lot of characters forward. He really moves Johnny forward. He definitely move Daniel forward, which is fantastic. And him and Samantha Lawrence, Mary Mauser, their relationship is only frayed but strengthened in ways. And Samantha Lawrence gets a lot to do in this series, and I was really happy Mary Mauser stepped up to the plate for this. And then there's Anthony LaRusso, played by Griffin Santopiero. I mean, this kid lost weight. I'll say that for him. I thought they recast the kid, but no, he's lost a lot of weight, coming to his own. It's funny because what the best thing about this show is the father-son relationship, the father-daughter relationships, the role model father-figure relationships. You know, it was a big part of the original movies, with Kreese kind of taking Lawrence under his wings and with Miyagi kind of taking LaRusso under his wings. It's always been a big staple of the Karate Kid franchise, whether it's the movies or the series Cobra Kai. It's always been there, and they play that so brilliantly. Like, that's what's so good about these kids as well, because Tana Buchanan, I'm not massively into him. Like, I'm not really overly ecstatic about his character. Like, I think his character's not that great as Johnny's son, but what he can do as an actor. And when I say the character's not that great, I don't mean the actor. I mean, because Tana Buchanan is firing on all cylinders. He makes me feel everything he wants me to feel. He just makes everything work. I just think his character has, I don't think it's ran its course, but it's only just now, at the tail end of this series, that I finally saw what Tana Buchanan was doing. Like, yeah, okay, is he out for himself? Is he just trying to piss off other people? Is he just trying to make friends? At the end of this series, you know his direction, the conflict within this kid, because he has to play the most layered character, if you ask me. He's got a little bit of everything. He's got the good side, the dark side. He's just got everything going on. And finding that balance as a young actor for him, I don't know, it's pretty cool. But in this cheesy, campy, nostalgia-filled 80s. And that brings me to my new favorite character. And I'll put it down to two, maybe three reasons on this. The new character comes in, and if you remember Sean from, I think it was the last series he was in, him and Robbie had a little bit of to and fro, and when Robbie was in juvie, he became kind of Sean was kind of like his bully, but then taught him the ways through karate, as is always the way, isn't it? And so we've got a new character in the form of his brother, and his brother is called Kenny. Just this new young kid coming in. He's the same age bracket as Anthony LaRusso. So of course, he's not going to be cutting it with the rest of our guys. He's going to be mostly spending a lot of time with those guys. Robbie kind of takes him under his wing because he's being bullied by Anthony. And again, just another mirror of the original franchise, the original trilogy, where Daniel's being bullied by the Cobra Kai's. Now you have Daniel's son bullying a future Cobra Kai. The fact that Daniel's son's bullying anyone is mental, but he is, because that's what this show does best. And we have a fantastic scene. I pointed this out on Facebook and on Twitter as well. You've got these guys who are massive, massive fans of this show, from the writers to the creators to the directors. They're just fans of this show. They're fans of this universe. How can these guys, who are just playing ultimate fan service, do something like this scene? Kenny's the new kid in town, sort of doesn't really know anyone. He's coming to a new high school, gets to the high school, and he starts being bullied by Anthony LaRusso. He doesn't really know the history of anything like this. He doesn't know who Anthony LaRusso is, really, but he's being bullied by him, and he doesn't like it. He's a bit of a nerd, so he goes home and he's playing, like, Dungeon Lair, I think it's called, which is a callback to, like, Season 1 and 2 when Dimitri and Eli used to play it. So he's kind of into this game, and he basically gets cyber-baited into going to meet this girl dressed up in fancy dress at the park. He gets there and we realize that it's actually Anthony LaRusso and his gang of little dickbags. So they end up like chasing the kid, trying to fight the kid. They jump over a metal grate. Now, the only reason I bring this scene up is because that is almost scene for scene, beat for beat, Daniel Lawrence versus Johnny Lawrence in the original movie, you know, with the skeleton costumes. Turns up in fancy dress and these guys are all there, and they're going to beat the crap out of him, chase him through the park, and then he jumps over the metal fence and he runs away. How do you pay fan service like that? So effortlessly, so brilliantly, embellishing on a storyline that you're just about to create doesn't really hinge on that. But when you look back at it, it's like, holy shit, that's what they were doing. And they did it so well Okay, so these guys are doing fan service for us. Lana Wachowski, who I mentioned at the start, has her own intellectual property that she created, then makes a sequel and can't make anything half decent out of it. It's a dumpster fire rabbit turd of a movie, and that was her original movie.
Sorry.
But that kind of sets up Kenny going forward. Robbie kind of takes him under his wing because he wants to learn karate so he can defend himself. And yeah, Kenny might not be the best student for Robbie. I will say that if there's one thing this series has been missing, or as a whole, series 1, 2, 4 so far, as a whole, is actual bad guys. I know Kreese was a bad guy. I know Johnny was kind of a little bit of a bad guy early on. Hawk's a bit of an asshole. Tori's a bit of a bad guy. But something all these people have is redeeming qualities. They all have some redeeming qualities. Everybody in this show is layer upon layer upon layer. There's so many stories going on and there's so much happening in their lives that they flip-flop, they change, they have changes of hearts. They do all this kind of stuff. And I love it. I love all of it. But I do kind of want one person to remain a baddie all the way through. Even the dick bags at Cobra Kai, I can see good qualities in these guys. You can see that they're just being manipulated in certain ways. Kreese towards the end of season 4, and even in season 3, I'll say Kreese's story in season 3, I had mass amounts of sympathy for him. And if you can make me feel sympathy for a character like John Kreese, you've won. You've absolutely won. Because we're supposed to hate him. But now, at the same time, you're meant to love him. Same with Johnny Lawrence. You wouldn't have bought season 1 if you didn't think that. So, I do think the series is missing an actual, fully-fledged bad guy. And we kind of maybe have that going forward for season 5. And I don't think it's going to be a massive surprise, but it's Terry Silver. Like, no spoilers whatsoever. But where we leave Terry Silver at the end of season 5... is almost Karate Kid 3 levels Terry Silver. This man could be our new Darth Vader of the Cobra Kai universe. I hope. I really do hope. But alongside him, you also have Little Kenny. Little Kenny, where his story goes, was not at all what I thought was going to happen. I really didn't. I think this kid has the potential to be the new bad boy Mike Barnes. Unless we get Mike Barnes. But that's another thing that I just absolutely wanted to see. I want to see going forward, season 5, let's have a series of where we actually have some dark, twisted, bad guys. Let's do it. Let's go for it. Because even Terry Silver, I feel a little bit sorry for Terry Silver in ways, but I think you're kind of meant to, and then you get the bait and switch, and happy days. Personally, I'm going to wrap this up a little bit because I'm not really talking too much about the plot because I don't want to spoil it for anyone. The series is fantastic. For me, this series was the best. And I thought season 2 was excellent. I thought season 3 was superb. I think this series is just fantastic. Are there problems with it? Yes, there are. Because there are some motivations in here that flip-flop so much that I tend to forget whose side people are on. However, what's great about that is, and I pointed out again, what's great about that is when you get to the end of the series, there's certain things that happen early on that it seemed like they dropped it. It seemed like it didn't really mean much. But then you get to the last 3 episodes and oh my God, they pay everything off in such a big bad way. They knew what they were doing all along. I genuinely think this is probably one of the best seasons of any show I've seen in a long time. I think they built it beautifully. I think every character is played exquisitely, and I think all storylines, even though sometimes it seems like there's too much going on, all storylines wrap around nicely. Going into season 5, I couldn't be any more excited. I was a little bit worried with it going to Netflix and not being on YouTube. I was a little bit worried that it was going to kind of be neutered a little bit and lose some of its balls, but if anything, it looks like it's getting ballsier. I mean, the final tournament, I haven't spoken anything about the final tournament, but Jesus, it's good. Every single fight they show you, every single montage they show you, because there's a few montages in the series, every single piece of the All-Valley tournament was just incredible. Some of the moves that these kids are putting out there are just incredible. Unbelievably choreographed. There's a few really nice big fight scenes throughout the series, but I feel like they held back a little bit on the fight scenes till we got to the tournament, because that's where all the marbles are, and it pays off in a big bad way. Yeah, I'm really looking forward going into season 5. I don't think we're going to get much of Miguel. Like I say, he's off doing Blue Beetle. You can't fault him for that. That's going to be a big move for him in the movie world, so that's awesome. I'm looking forward to seeing some Samantha Larusso, because where we kind of leave her, I've not really spoken much about her because she has a really good arc in this series that I don't really want to get into on here, unless I'm going to do spoilers, which I'm not. But I just genuinely think season 4 was wonderful, and going forward, I'm looking forward to it. Kind of Daniel and Johnny are maybe not on the same page anymore. It's all looking a little bit frayed, a little bit fractured, but these guys definitely have a lot of love for each other now, and I can't wait to see what we do going forward with season 5. Again, this has been Nerdly Out Loud. My name is Kevin Howden. We are the official channel of nerdly.co.uk. Please do all those wonderful things, which I didn't ask you to do at the start. I just wanted to get straight into this review. Please do all those wonderful things that I should have asked you to do, and that is to like, subscribe, and ding that notification bell. You will get more notifications from me going forward, because I've got a lot of episodes to drop. The studio will be fixed soon. We will be back to our good old selves. But with that, I'm going to let you go. Please do come back and watch all of our videos, watch all our previous videos, and check out nerdly.co.uk.